Hello everybody, today I'm at the Chicago Auto Show taking a look at this 2023 Ford Explorer Platinum all-wheel drive. Starting off up front, we are going to have the platinum style chrome grille. This guy has a 360 degree camera system. Your front facing camera is going to be right there underneath the Ford logo. Full LED headlight and fog light package. Front facing parking sensors in the bottom portion of the bumper. Really thick plastic fender flare to protect against rock chips. Coming down to the wheel and tire setup, it looks like we have some Scorpion Zero all-season tires. And it looks like the tire size on that is a 275/45 R20. I can't make that out specifically. 21, I think this is a 21-inch tall tire. Black applique along the running boards. Explorer is stamped into the black plastic applique right there. Black mirror cap up top. 360 degree camera system on the mirror is going to be right there. Color matched with brushed chrome trim on the door handles. Brushed chrome trim up top on the roof rack. Right around here we have your lockable capless fuel fill port. Full LED accent C-channel tail lamp with incandescent signal and reverse lamp. I believe your blind spot monitor is located in here as well. Platinum badging is going to be on the driver's side. Parking sensors are going to be integrated into the uppermost portion of the plastic portion of the bumper. We have dual exhaust with this guy, as well as your 7-pin and 4-pin connectors to the left of the trailer hitch. Your backup camera is going to be under the L and O in Explorer. Explorer is stamped into the trim piece. We have your trunk release right here. Your four-wheel drive badge is going to be right there. I think I misspoke and said this was all-wheel drive. It is four-wheel drive. Really beautiful white metallic flake exterior color. I'm hoping that's coming through for you guys on camera. This is a very sporty, luxurious-looking SUV. Let's take a closer look at the interior. So I do want to apologize for the lighting in this vehicle. I am trying my best to lighten it up. I will try and fix it in post if I need to. But starting off over here on the left-hand side, we have all of the window controls for the vehicle, the mirror controls for the vehicle, your lock and unlock buttons, as well as your three-seat memory. This Platinum is going to have your B&O premium audio group, as you'd expect on a Platinum. Right over here, we have the trunk release button, the lockable gas cap button, rotary dial selector for the lighting of the vehicle, your dimmer switch for your instrument cluster as well. Coming up top to the instrument cluster, it is 100% digital, which is sweet. Very, very customizable on what you can monitor. Coming back to the steering wheel, we have a very nice soft leather wrap steering wheel with mild bolsters at 10 and 2. Right over here on the left side of the steering wheel, we have all the safety features for the vehicle, including your gap adjustment for your adaptive cruise control, lane keep assist, regular cruise control buttons, as well as some steering wheel mounted audio controls. Over on the right side, we have the control pad for the center instrument cluster, as well as some more phone call and audio controls mounted on the steering wheel. Now, I believe this is a first for Ford. They actually give you the Ford logo with this brushed, distressed wood look that kind of matches the real wood-looking trim down here. It's actually pretty cool and quite refreshing from the usual design features they give you with some of these vehicles. Coming to the instrument or the touchscreen display, I believe this is an 11.5 or 11-inch vertical touchscreen stack. It is similar to the Mach-E, where you can control like your zone lighting, stuff like that. I believe this has the card system as well, so you can have your navigation, you can have your audio, stuff like that. As you can see, you have navigation and stuff down here. It is not as responsive as the brand new stuff, but still a lot more responsive than it's been in the past. We have your apps right here. I believe this has wireless CarPlay and Android Auto. And even though it is vertical, it doesn't look like it's too oversized. It kind of looks like it belongs right there. Push button start right here. You got this real wood looking trim that's very similar, if not the same, to the wood on the steering wheel. All the physical buttons for the radio are going to be right here, as well as your parking sensors off button, hazard light button, and then your toggle between your 360 degree camera buttons right there. Below that, we have all the physical controls for the dual zone heating and cooling for the vehicle,
The driver and captain's chairs are heated and ventilated, and then your heated steering wheel button's going to be in the middle right there. Although you can't see it, I will try and fix that in post. Underneath this little storage tray bin, we've got a 12-volt outlet, a USB outlet, a USB Type-C outlet, and a pretty big size storage mat. Cut out for cord management. Perfect spot for a key fob or some change. Two cup holders right here, rotary dial selector gear shifter, electronic parking brake, hold button, drive mode button, as well as your traction control and hill descent control buttons. You have a wireless charging mat right here. Lift up on this, giving us access to a removable storage tray. And then down in here, we have a 12-volt power outlet. Pretty nice, comfortable leather seats with platinum stitched into the seat backs. This guy has one glove box. It is right here, which is very big for this size vehicle, I may add. Again, that wood trim continues throughout. Soft leather on the dash. I'd say a solid 95% of the dashboard is soft touch leather. Up top in the vanity, it is going to be LED lit for your passenger as well as the driver. The driver vanity is going to get a three-door universal garage remote. Up top on the headliner, we have some glasses storage. All of your dome map light master controls, as well as all the buttons for the power sliding twin pane sunroof. And then we have an auto dimming rear view mirror right here. So overall, I do like the interior of the Explorer. I think they did a good job. I like the vertical touchscreen like this. I'm not a huge fan of the gloss black in here, as you can see or not see. It does get fingerprints and it does get smudges on it pretty easily. If they would have done like some sort of wood thing or maybe like a matte black texture, that would have been really cool. But I think this is new for 2023, and this is very luxurious, definitely bears the platinum name. Let's take a look at the back and see how much leg room we have. Tons of room back here with these captain chairs. This is a, I believe, a six-seater. So you got two, two, and two in the back behind here. Each door has this two-tone kind of like beige and darker like cocoa brown color. They also have these sun visor privacy shades, which is pretty sweet. All of your air conditioning vents, hanger hooks, and dome map lights are pushed to the outermost edge of the headliner because of the twin pane sunroof. All of your rear HVAC controls are going to be back here, including your heated captain's chairs. You have a media hub right here with a USB, USB Type-C, and 110 volt, 150 watt power outlet on the right side. And then over here you have a fold down cup holder. You also have cup holders here and here. Getting into the back is pretty easy with this pass through. However, unfortunately, I am a little bit too big to fit back in there. I already know based on experience, I will not fit back in there. However, you do have cup holders on both passenger and driver side, if you can see that. And again, getting out is pretty easy. You can either use this center pass through, or you can push this button right here on both seats, and these seats will fold up like so. If it's hooked up, I don't think it's hooked up right now because it's in demo mode, but typically you'd push this button. This seat would kind of move forward and up so you can get in and get out. Let's take a quick look at the back and see how much cargo space we have. So like I said, to open the trunk of this vehicle, you come up to the right of the Arn Explorer. There's a little arrow here. You push it, it pops open for you, and you're good to go. Now you have some in-floor storage on both driver and passenger sides, as well as some nice deep underfloor storage here as well. On the passenger side, you have a lighted cargo lamp. And above that, you have the right and left power folding seat option. So you push that button, they fold up. You push it again, they fold down. As you can see, I would not have had much, if any, room back in there, but your air conditioning vents and your LED dome map lights are gonna be up top. With the seats in the upright most position, you don't have a crazy amount of storage, but again, push this button, they fold all the way down, and that almost doubles, or if not triples, your storage. You also have a 12 volt outlet right here, keeping devices charged. And then once you're done doing your business back here, you can come up to the passenger side, push the trunk button, and then lock the vehicle from back here as well. So there you have it. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving me a like and share. If you want to keep up to date with more Chicago Auto Show content and
vehicle walkthroughs in the future, please consider subscribing to the channel and be sure to check out all the affiliate links in the description below. Like always, thanks for watching and have a great day.